Hello friends, today we will discuss limit test for iron and lead. This comes under the Pharmaceutical Impurities 6th part. So limit test for iron, the principle. The limit test for iron is based on the formation of pale pink to deep reddish purple color by reaction of iron with thioglycolic acid in the presence of citric acid in a solution made alkaline with ammonia solution. The color is due to the formation of coordination compound ferrous thioglycolate. The original state of the oxidation of the iron is immaterial since thioglycolic acid also reduces ferric ion to the ferrous state. So this is the reaction involves in the limit test for iron. So the color produced is compared with the standard color containing a definite quantity of the iron by viewing transversely through the Nessner cylinders. About the Nessner cylinders, we have discussed in earlier slides. So the citric acid is added in the official process to prevent the precipitation of iron by ammonia. Iron gets precipitated in the form of ferrous hydroxide and ferric hydroxide depending upon the oxidation state of the iron in the presence of ammonia. Citric acid makes soluble complex with iron and ammonia will not be able precipitate iron and it will just provide alkaline medium. So method according to the IP 1996, the specified quantity of the substance being examined is dissolved in water or a solution is prepared as directed in the individual monograph and transferred to the Nessner cylinder. 2 ml of 20% weight by volume solution of iron free citric acid and 0.1 ml of thioglycolic acid are added and mixed. The solution is made alkaline with iron free ammonia solution and diluted to 50 ml with water. The solution is stirred with a glass rod and allowed to stand for 5 minutes. Any color produced is not more intense than that obtained by treating 2 ml of iron standard solution, that is 20 parts per million iron, in the same manner in place of the solution being examined. Preparation, this is the method for preparation of iron standard solution, which is 20 parts per million iron. Dilute 1 volume of 0.1726% weight by volume solution of ferric ammonium sulfate in 0.05 molar sulfuric acid in 10 volumes with distilled water. It contains iron in the ferric state. This was all about limit test for iron. Now come towards the limit test for lead. The principle, the limit test for lead is based on the reaction between the lead and diphenyl thiocarbazone, which is also known as diathiazone, in an alkaline medium to form lead diathiazonate complex. The lead present as an impurity in the substance is separated by extracting an alkaline solution with diathiazone extraction solution. The interference by other metal ions is eliminated by adjusting the optimum pH for the extraction by using reagents like ammonium citrate, potassium cyanide and hydroxyl amine hydrochloride. The original color of diathiazone in chloroform is green, while the lead diathiazone complex is violet in color. The intensity of the violet color of the complex depending upon the quantity of lead present in the solution is compared with that of standard color produced by treating standard solution containing a definite amount of lead in the similar manner. So we have to compare the color produced by diethylene in chloroform, which is in general green, and the lead diethylene complex is violet in color. So if the color produced is violet, then our test sample will be failed. So this was the reaction. The lead reacts with diethylene in the alkaline medium, makes this complex, which is the lead diethylenate complex. So the method, according to IP 1996, prepare the sample as directed in the monograph and transfer to the separator. Unless otherwise directed, in the monograph add 6 ml of ammonium nitrate solution and 2 ml of hydroxylamine hydrochloride solution. To this add 2 drops of phenol red solution and to make the solution alkaline, red in color, by adding strong ammonia solution. If necessary, cool the solution and add 2 ml of potassium cyanide solution. Immediately extract the solution with 5 ml portion of diethylene extraction solution until it retains green color. Combine the diethylene extract and transfer to a second separator. Shake the combined diethylene extract for 30 seconds with 30 ml of 1% volume by volume nitric acid solution and discard the chloroform layer. To the nitric acid solution, add exactly 5 ml of diethylene standard solution and shake it for 30 seconds. The violet color of the chloroform layer should not be more intense than that obtained by the treating a volume of standard lead solution, that is 1 parts per million lead, equivalent to the amount of lead permitted in the substance being examined in the same manner as that of solution being examined. So these are the method of preparation. Very first method of preparation of standard lead solution, that is 1 part per million lead, dissolve 0.400 gram of lead nitrate in water containing 2 ml of dilute nitric acid and add sufficient water to produce 250 ml. This gives standard lead solution, and with standard lead solution again prepared by diluting 1 volume of standard lead solution to 1000 volumes with water. So the method for preparation of diethylene extraction solution, dissolve 30 mg of diethylene in 1000 ml of chloroform and add 5 ml of ethanol, which is 95%. The solution is stored in refrigerator before use. The solution is shaken with about half of its volume of 1% volume by volume nitric acid solution and acid is discarded. The method for preparation of diethylene standard solution, dissolve 10 mg of diethylene in 1000 ml of chloroform. So this was all about limit test for lead and iron. So these are the references which are used to make the slide presentation. Thanking you very much. And in the next presentation, we will learn about limit test for heavy metals. Thanking you again.